Okay, children, page number 10. Yeah. Now we are going to do interrogative sentences. They are of two types: yes and no sentences. Okay? WH questions. Now we should remember that in an interrogative sentence, we place the auxiliary verb before the subject. And we always put a question mark at the end of an interrogative sentence. Now let us discuss this in details. They have bought sweets. They have bought sweets. They have bought sweets. Alright? Now this is a simple sentence. Now we have to change it to an interrogative sentence. So when we change it, especially remember, auxiliary verb, it will come in front. And it will become a capital letter. Capital, especially. Have they bought sweets? And do not forget to put a question mark. Question mark is a must. If you don't put question mark, then you will get wrong. In exam, you will not get marks. Now, in the above sentence is an example of a yes or no question. Here, are you Mrs. Sharma? We cannot say what. In this, we cannot use WH question, which means a question that can be answered in yes or no. Such a question begins with an auxiliary verb. Some auxiliary verbs are is, do, have, can, was, where, had, which help other words to form tenses and voices. What are you looking for? Question word. Auxiliary verb is are and subject is you looking for. The above sentence is an example of WH question. In this we cannot answer no or yes. We have to say what we are doing. This question cannot be answered in yes or no. And begin with a question, words such as what, why, when, where, whom, whose or which. Underline this, children. This is very important. These are all your question. Okay? Question words. Now, WH questions begin with interrogative pronouns like who, whom, whose, and are also used to ask questions. These are used only for persons. Who has written this letter? Answer. Anil has written this letter. We cannot say no has written, yes has written. So this is a WH question. Whose bag is this? It is Sonal's bag. Whom do you want to reward? I want to reward Alka. Interrogative pronoun who is used as a subject. Whom refers to the object. If that object is there, we have to use whom. And subject is there, we have to use who. Example, who called you? Subject is who and object is you. Whom are you calling? Object is whom. Then you is subject here. Nowadays, informal conversation, who is commonly used instead of whom. Whom does she want to meet? Who does she want to meet? Both the statements are correct. Now, who and whom both can be used. In written English, we generally use the form given in sentence A, as it is formal. In spoken English, we generally use the form given in sentence B, as it is informal. Now, what and which are also interrogative pronouns. Now, do you know what is a pronoun? A word that is used in place of a noun. Poonam madam is an English teacher. Instead of Poonam madam, I will put she. She is an English teacher. So she is the pronoun. A word used in place of noun is a pronoun. Okay? What is he? He is a doctor. What is she? She is a professor. Okay? What is used for persons to inquire about their trade or profession? Means what work they are doing. And what is also used to refer to things. What is in the bag? My clothes are in the bag. Things. What are you eating? I am eating an apple. Again a thing. Which is used when we ask about things or about one particular thing in a group. Which is your hotel? Which of these paintings have you made? Now, which is also used to ask questions about persons when we have to select a person from a group. Which of you have the application? That means who is having the application? We can use which here. Which of the boys is ready to play? Indicating a group. Now, interrogative adjectives are also used to ask questions. What snakes, which girl, and whose book? Interrogative adverbs are also used to ask questions. Where, when, how, why, how often, how long, and so on. Now, these we have to change, we have to rearrange. Okay, I'll just speak and explain you a few, and then I fill the page and I'm going to send you to copy in your. You have to copy with pencil in very good, neat and clean handwriting, children. See, they are coming now. They are coming now. Okay, this is an assertive sentence. Simple. Full stop is a must. Now we want to change it into a interrogative. How can we change? We will take R. Auxiliary verb R. A will become capital. T small. Are they coming now? And a question mark. Now he is playing with them. Is he playing with them? History is her favorite subject. Is history her favorite subject? They will come at 4 o'clock. Will they come at 4 o'clock? You are Mr. Gupta. Are you Mr. Gupta? And everywhere in the end you have to put a question mark because it is an interrogative sentence. Tanu and Manu will come to the wedding. Will Tanu and Manu come to the wedding?
Bus, man.
The movie was boring. The movie was boring. Was the movie boring? They are at home. Are they at home? She is our neighbor. Is she our neighbor? All the first letters will be capital. Okay? You know the capital? Okay, she is our new neighbor. Is she our new neighbor? Mithul has invited you to the party. Has Mithul invited you to the party? Now in this children, has and Mithul is a proper noun, so it will be capital only. Both. In has Mithul invited you to the party? Now exclamatory sentences.
Banka.
1.5 pages. Okay children, tomorrow we'll continue this lesson. 1.5 pages left, okay? Till that you read and try to remember what I have explained to you. Okay? Bye.